Hey, what's up, everybody? Welcome back to another stand-up comedy act featuring me, Eric Carter. Now, we're going to talk about driving. Yes, my favorite topic of all time, driving. Sometimes I wish I could just do this, snap my fingers, and then teleport to where I need to go, but that doesn't happen like that. Or be like zombies, build a teleporter, step on it, and then be to work or school or wherever you gotta be, doctor's appointment, dentist appointment. Just snap your fingers or step on a teleporter and boom, you're there. Or create a wormhole, you know, down below here and just go in there and be like, and then pop out in front of your coworker and be like, hey buddy, I'm here, and scare the shit out of them, you know. I wish life was that easy, but it's not. Driving. Oh, just hit 100,000 miles on my car. This is my second car I own, right? Second car I have owned. I've owned two cars so far in my lifetime. And yeah, that's insane, right? Two cars, jeez. Alright, but anyways, here we go. First time ever driving a car was basically when I was 16 years old. I had to take the driver's training stuff, 15, 16, around there, you know, you need to do all that so you could drive, legally drive and stuff like that. I had a mean instructor, right? He was really freaking mean. Like, I mean, I understand why he was so strict the way he was. I mean, he could have been so nicer and so nice to me and do it. We were in the parking lot, right? We were just, you know, driving like a damn racetrack. He's like, slow down! Slow down! You're going too freaking fast! You're going too freaking fast! And then he was saying all this shit. I'm like, he's like, dude, you gotta do it slow. I'm like, we're in a fucking parking lot. What bad could happen? I don't know. You could fly into that fence. So he pissed me off. He made it to where I didn't want to drive that day anymore. He made it feel like I didn't want to get my freaking license. Like, he pissed me off so bad, I almost said, all right, I'm done, and walked off. I was about to, but then he's like, yo, you walk off, then you're never getting your license. You better do it now. And my parents paid $255 for it, so I had to do it. So I had no freaking choice. I just had to stick down and bear with the bullshit because, man, he was a freaking asshole. But I had to deal with it, so. As we got further into it, I learned how to parallel park. I learned how to stop. You know, there's like a little white line you gotta have. You stop there, then you back in. I did that pretty well. Parallel parking I had troubles with, but I managed to get through. Then it was time to go on the road. So we went on the road, and what it was is when I was driving, you know how people like to stay closer to the white line? Well, I kept going towards the median, and every time you'd be like, get your ass back this way, so I would get over this way and do that, and then as I learned, I tried to start staying, you know, by the white line, because it's more safer than crossing the median and causing an accident. Now, with those cars, he's got a brake over on his passenger side in case I do something wrong. And there was instance, he has hit that a few times. I've almost passed the red light. I almost hit another vehicle. I scared the shit out of him and made him hit it. So yeah, I was a terrible driver at first. Like, I was the most crappiest driver. But until we got more and more sessions of practice, I did fairly well. Like, I had a girl. There was a girl on the other lane, like, from the stoplight, she was over, I don't know if she was making a lot, she was looking over to me and she was smiling like, hey buddy, man, he's hot, dude, I wonder how old he is, you know, thinking like that. He's like, hey man, how old are you, thinking like that, and the instructor was like, that girl's hitting on you and you don't even know it. And I was like, okay, whatever, dude. And then we hit the expressway and I did fairly well. Like, he would tell me to change lanes. I would change lanes like that and change lanes, change it back, you know, do it, checking the blind spot, you know, like checking the blind spots, you know, get over casually, you know, do the same thing over here, you know, checking the blind spot, get over. Make sure you're using your blinkers and all that. Got through it, no problem. Now it was time to get the road test done. I was 16, First time taking the road test. Went to a place in Owosso, and it was bad. The instructor was terrible. Like, I did the stop, you know, stopping up ahead of the white line, like you're supposed to. Then after you said, all right, you're good, and then you had to back up, you know, back up this way into it. So basically, you stop here, and then you kind of go back, and then kind of do this number. And then you've got to be even with the cones and all that crap. And then, as soon as that's done, you have to come out like that. Well, I'll do it this way so you guys can see it. Come out, then had to parallel park, and I couldn't pass that. I had three attempts. He's like, you're done. You failed. You're done. He had me in freaking tears. I was bawling my eyes out. Because he was like, you failed. You suck. Learn how to parallel park and then you come back and do it. I was like, I don't know how to fucking do that. I mean, he could have been nice about it, not being a dick and be like, yeah, man, you fucking failed. You suck. You can't parallel park. You're not going to fucking get your license. I said, all right, dude. So he had me in fucking tears, basically. I was like, are you kidding me right now? So, second time, I was 17, close to 18. I was probably, close to 18. My second time I did it, I did everything right, but I messed up turning left on a one-way. I didn't turn the closest lane to me. I turned the lane out further. My excuse was my windows were foggy. So he failed me. Just, I don't know. He just didn't want to. He wanted to pass me because I did everything else right. But he didn't want me to. He didn't want to pass me because I turned not to the nearest lane. I turned in the second lane. You're not supposed to do that in case people are trying to turn left in there or trying, you know. Or there's a car there or whatever. That's why you failed me. So third time's the charm, right? I hope so. So we do it a third time, 2 days before my 18th birthday. Now the excuse was I had to get my license before I was 18 or I would have to retake driver's training all over again. That was the scare. So I had no choice but to pass it this time. What do? I passed it. Flying colors. I probably messed up the parallel parking a little bit. I had maybe, you only get 6 points. I probably should have mentioned that before. You only get 6 points on the parking lot doing all this parking sting. So if you mess up all the 6 points, you're done. So I got through it with 5 points. So I only missed like maybe 1 or 2 points. So I got through it with 4 points. Got on the road. Did everything right. There was a lot of freaking pedestrians out though. Oh my God. Like that was a nightmare. But I did everything right, went on the expressway, you know, listened to him. He told me to turn right one time, and it was a one-way. I'm like, I can't turn right on a one-way. Good. I was seeing if you were paying attention. So that was awesome. The first time I ever got pulled over from a cop. Well, technically my first ticket was an accident I had back in 2009. And I was sicker than a dog. I had to take my middle brother to driver's training. So we did that. Took him to driver's training. And I made it there fine. I had to take my younger brother with me because he wasn't old enough to be home by himself at the time. So I took him there. Man, I wasn't feeling good. Got back home. I took a nap. I told my brother, younger brother to wake me up when it's time to go pick up my middle brother from driver's training. Because I was not feeling good. I had a headache, a sore throat. I was fucking miserable, man. I was like, and then it was time to go. I go there fine to pick him up. I come home and start coming home. There's this intersection, okay, that bends this way, like bends this way and then bends that way. And there's a stop. I looked again. Then I start going. This van shows up out of freaking nowhere on the right. He shows up, bounces off the bumper, the front bumper of my car. He flips into the ditch. And I'm thinking to myself, what the hell just happened? Like, if I would have sped up, the car would have been in my lap, in my middle brother's lap. If I sped up even more, the car would be in my younger brother's lap. So, to this day, I probably wouldn't exist if I would have sped up, or, you know, sped a little bit, the car would be in me and my brother's lap, or the younger brother would have got it. But I scared the crap out of my younger brother. He does not want to drive at all after that incident. And I feel bad that I did that to him. But hey, shit happens when you drive. And that was a $150 ticket because I had the stop sign. That's why. So that was my very first accident. And oh my God. And I wasn't feeling well. I was sitting there an hour. I was thirsty. I threw up on the side of the freaking road because that's how I felt. So everything's done. I had to call my grandpa up. We had to tow it to my house and drove us home. I felt so bad. I thought I was going to get my ass chewed out. My mom was going to surprise us with Little Caesar's Pizza, right? She comes home to a wrecked, total car. And it was my mom's car, too. And she's like, oh my God, what'd you do to my car? Oh my God. And she was going to surprise us with pizza. Well, she came home to surprise of a wrecked total car. Man, terrible driver I am. So that was my first ticket. Now, the second ticket I ever gotten, this is when I was working in retail, and I was going through a place where it was it went 25 to 30 miles an hour to 35 miles an hour. I wasn't in a hurry to get home. I was in the 30 mile an hour zone. I was doing 35. The speed limit sign was probably about that far away. Here, fuck, get pulled over by a cop. And I'll tell you what, I wish I had a box of donuts because that cop was in a bad freaking mood. I thought I was going to get shot that night. And because he's like, put both hands on the wheel. I was like, I was going to get you the insurance, you know, the proof of insurance, the registration, and my license. No, put your hands on the freaking wheel. And then he asked for the stupid, you know, the stuff you need when you get pulled over by a cop. He gave me a ticket for doing 5 over, and the speed limit sign was not even a foot away from the freaking, as soon as I passed it. I'm like, are you freaking kidding me? Guess how much the ticket cost? Take a freaking guess. Pause the video in the comment section. Take a guess at how much that freaking ticket was. $125 freaking dollars. I'm like, are you kidding me? And the only way you can find out is if you call the courthouse and be like, yes, this is Eric Carter. I got a ticket for speeding, and could you see how much it's going to be? And she's the lady on the other end of the phone was like, yeah, sir, that's going to be $125. And the only way you could pay that, either by check, well, I didn't have any checks at the time, so I had to get a money order and do it that way. Don't speed, even though it's 5 over, you never know. Speaks of the time where I got pulled over another time. I was doing maybe 10 over. And this cop was in one heck of a mood. Like, I don't know if he got laid or what, man. Or he got some good donuts at Dunkin' Donuts or whatever. I don't know what the case is, man. He was in a heck of a good mood. He's like, sir, how you doing today? I'm like, yeah, I'm doing pretty good. Can I see your license and registration and proof of insurance? I said, sure. He took my license. I had no points at the time. And checked me all out. I didn't have any felonies or nothing like that, you know, and stuff like that. And he comes back, slow down. Have a nice day. Gives me my license and all that proof of insurance. And I'm good to go. I'm like, that's the first time I ever got out of a freaking ticket. I'm like, man, I wonder if I could do that more often. Wait, I'm not a girl. Fuck, can't do that shit. All right, here's a good topic to talk about with this driving stuff, man. Like, There's so many different drivers out there, right? So many different drivers out there. You got your risky ones, you got your slow ones, you got the elderly drivers, you got the first-time drivers, you got people rushing, people road raging, pissing you off, tailgaters, all whatever you got, you name it. Let's start off with people turning out in front of you. Oh my God, I don't know how many times I could tell you. I could tell you going to work, you get cars so impatient to wait, they'll turn out in front of you and you're like, bitch, asshole, fucking bitch. There was one time the guy did that and I threw my hands up. I don't know if you guys can see me when I do it. Threw my hands out like this, hoping he could see me in the rear view. I'm like this the whole time. We're at a stoplight and I'm here like this. I'm shaking my head like, what the fuck are you doing, dude? You just fucking... If there was ice on the road and you try doing that, oh my God, I'm going to hit you with my car. That's just how it's going to be. People turning out in front of you. Then you got people going on red and you have to hesitate. I don't even think when I drive. I think what other people are doing before I decide what I'm going to do, because I don't want to get in a freaking accident and sit there with a cop, you know, waiting for all that shit, you know. Then you got people who are slower than hell. You can't pass. They're doing 10 or 15 miles below the speed limit. You're trying to pass. I don't want a honk to be a bat, you know, be a meanie and be like, hey, let's go, speed limit, you know. Ugh. Driving. Yeah, and my first car, the Neon that I had, that was my first car. That cost me about $1,000. And it was an okay car. I had to get gas every 4 days. The gas was, I think, was like 10 or 15 miles to the gallon. Not very good on the gas. I kind of wish I could fart in the freaking gas tank and be like, there's my gas, you know. If I could do that, you know how much money I could save on gas? Quite a bit. Or even piss in the damn... where you put your gas, what is it, gas tank or fuel tank or whatever you call that thing, piss in it, use your piss as gas. I wish that was a thing, right? If only life was that easy, right? So it was good. It was time. Then I had $1,000 worth of repairs, you know. It's like Dad talked me into getting another car. It was a Cobalt, so I went and got it and trade in my other car. You know what the dealer got, the person that was selling me, or I traded in my car, you know what the car dealer told me? He's like, man, I'm going to take the doors off and use it as a freaking four-wheeler or a go-kart. And I'm like, dude, why didn't I think of that? That would have been cool, you know? And he's like, yeah, I could use it as a go-kart. I couldn't believe it. But the car I got now is a 2009 Cobalt. Just hit 100,000 miles on it. I'm going to dread the day where I got to get another car. God, owning a car is not cheap. Like, I just spent over $1,000 on my Cobalt for tires and new braking system and all that. So, yeah, owning a car is not cheap. It's like owning an art. Like, it's almost like a car is almost like a house. Just think of it for a minute. Let's say you have over $1,000 of repairs, right, on your car. And then you got, on top of that, your house. How do you pay it off? You need to get a good-ass job. That's all that there is to it. I get this new car, this new Cobalt, right? I only had it for not even a week and I wreck it. Are you kidding me? This happened like 4 years ago. Like, I haven't even had it a full week and I already wrecked it. Now, what happened was, it was September 1st. I don't remember the year. I know it was September 1st. It had to be like... I know it was September 1st. I know it was Labor Day. And I was on my way to work. Okay, there's a one-way, right? So I turned. A girl turned as well. And she's in the far lane. You know, the slow lane. I'm in the other lane. So I'm right here. She's right here. She wants to turn left. She doesn't check her blind spot. That's the most important thing to do when you're changing lanes. Check your damn blind spot so you don't accidentally turn into freaking somebody. And that's what happened to me. She decides to turn. She hits me. I'm pissed. So I have to call work and tell them I can't come in because some crazy bitch turned out in front of her, you know, tried to turn, didn't check her blind spot. We got in a car accident. So I ain't coming in. Sorry. I was pissed. I missed out on holiday pay. I'm like, are you kidding me? I missed out on holiday pay. That's like the best. Because I only had to work. I had 4 hours. It was going to turn into 8 hours because of the holiday pay and premium pay and all that good shit. And time and a half if I worked the day before and day after. That didn't happen that day. I only got paid 22 hours. That was insult to injury. So I had to call my dad up. After I got done with the cop. I had to call my dad up. Hey, I got in a car accident. Don't get mad at me. It wasn't my fault. The cop comes up to me and says, who are you calling? I'm like, I'm calling my dad. Tell him what's going on. And the cop's like, well, you can tell him it wasn't your fault. She didn't check her blind spot. Well, the good news is she couldn't get out of her driver's side door, but I could still open my passenger seat door. Karma's a bitch. Don't piss her off or she's going to bite you in the ass. So that was kind of good news. I kind of got a free repair on that, and that was good news right there. So that's awesome. Just about done with this video. I know this is a little long. There's a lot to talk about with driving. Like, there's so many things about driving. I could just keep going and keep going. Because I've been driving now for almost 8 years. It'll be 8 years close to February, which is insane to think about. I believe it's 8 years. Yeah, 8 years. Because I'm going to be 26. Hard to believe it, right? So here's the last thing I'm going to talk about. And then I'm going to go ahead and end the video. It's probably going to be the longest comedy skit in a while. The first long one, actually. So here we go. I was coming home from work one night. I think it was about a year ago. Yeah, a year ago we went down. I was driving home, you know. I was doing 55. I didn't have my brights on because there was another car coming. And, you know, I don't like to blind them, so I'm polite and I turn my brights off. I'm going, you know, I'm going. Next thing you know, I see eyes in my windshield like this. Like, and I'm like, shit. That's a motherfucking deer. I hit the deer. The deer goes flying out over me. I mean, I hit that thing doing 55, man. I hit it. It was a buck, too. It was a huge deer. Hunters would be like, oh, my God. I'll show you a picture probably about right here. If I can find the picture. If not, I'm sorry. But, man. I did so much damage to that car. I did like $5,000 worth of damage. Now, I called my dad up. He's like, Dad, I hit it pretty hard because I couldn't start the car back up. That's how bad it was. And I asked him, what do I do? He's like, you're going to have to call 911. This is the first time ever calling 911. And it was on myself. So I dial up 911, and she's like, or he's like, I forget who it was. I think she's like, 911, what's your emergency? I'm like, I hit a deer. Are you okay? Is everybody okay? Yeah, we're fine. I'm fine. It was just me in the car. I just need to get a cop out here so I can report it. And he's like, all right, where are you at? So I tell him my location and stuff. And then Dad's coming out too. And, man, I had to sit there for a while. So I had to go out. Kind of in the ditch to go pee so I could pee and all that. So I was out of a car for a good 2 weeks before it got fixed. But man, that deer just jumped. Like, looking in the head, like, it was like this. Wait, hold on. Let me see if I can do it better. That's what it was like when the deer came in. Like, oh shit, you gonna hit me? Hell yeah, you are. All right, guys, that's gonna be it for the video. You guys enjoyed it? Make sure you leave it a like. Give it a thumbs up. Make it blue like my wall. Like my walls up here. Make the like button blue. That's highly appreciated. And subscribe if you're new around here. If you enjoyed it, please share it to your friends, and I will see you next time. Later!